class, Cork and Tipperary have met in the old athletic grounds. Markets Field, Parky Quay, Fitzgerald Stadium, Killarney and the Gaelic grounds in Limerick. This man is from Wexford. It's his second All-Ireland semi-final in a row. He refereed Cork against Dublin last year. This is it. We're about to witness history as it happens. The very first All-Ireland semi-final between Cork and Tipperary. Who will play Kilkenny on the first Sunday in September in the All-Ireland hurling final? That's the aim. That's the target. Cork won the toss. They've decided to play from left to right. Here comes Lara Corbett with the first opportunity. Shane O'Neill intercepts rather easily. Sends it along the surface over towards Stephen MacDonald, who in turn tries to find Lorcan McLaughlin. Christopher Joyce is there to lend assistance. Drives it long. First attack of the match for Cork. Here comes Alan Callaghan. He's lit up the championship so far this year, 2013. And you can see why. After 36 seconds, it's Alan Callaghan and a point.
And then look at it. We saw there the ball came straight in over the top. It should have been cut off. But Alan Callaghan has been brilliant for Cork this year, out in front. And that's a great start. His first major game in Croke Park. That'll settle.
Long tuck out from Darren Gleeson. Lorcan McLaughlin is there again. Here comes Daniel Carney. Long ball sent up by Damien Cahalan, but it's poor quality. It's easily gathered by James Barry. He's gone back into that full back line. We'll tell you more about the switches in a moment. Ball down towards Stephen MacDonald. John O'Dwyer is with him. Uses Shane O'Neill instead. John O'Dwyer, good work by the road run, by the way, chasing it. Here comes Shane O'Neill from Bishopstown, gives it long. Coming across is Paddy Stapleton. We've seen him at number two, he's now at number four. And, good play indeed by the Barzalima.
Yeah, looking at Paddy Stapleton there, he's picked up Pat Cronin and... You see Paddy Stapleton has switched corners, or Cahill Barrett has switched corners. He's over on Pat Horgan in the other corner. It looks like Alan Callaghan is lined out at full forward and been picked up by James Barry. So interesting matchups. You see Shane O'Neill gone in as well at full back on Seamus Callaghan.
Darren Gleeson takes the free. Dropping. Going back, Daniel Carney. Sends it down that left wing. Latching onto it is Conor Lahan. Tipperary backtracking, Kieran Bergen looks around and has the time and composure to give it long. Beautiful catch by Seamus Callanan, gives it inside Garrod Ryan. Bonner Marvis hovering. Here comes a Mill Street man, Mark Ellis, uses the short grip intelligently. It's centre half forward Bill Cooper. There's a Cork player down injured. We continue on with the long ball. Tipperary are there defensively. James Barry very visible with those luminous blue boots. Referee James Owens blows his whistle. It's a sideline ball, but it's also a chance for Stephen MacDonald to recover.
Yeah, Marty, a hectic starter. Stephen MacDonald got a knock under the last high ball. Just looking at Christopher Joyce, he's moved back from wing back into to pick up Lara Corbett in the corner. Here's the catch here by Seamus Callan, and he just came down there on Stephen MacDonald. But changes all over the place. Kieran Bergen has switched to right half-back, Parik Maher over at left half-back. So a lot of things we expected, and as I was saying before the game, that's what's happening in the modern game. Positions don't really mean a whole lot.
Brendan Maher, captain, Tipperary, Boris Ali. He was only the second player from the club to captain All-Ireland minor winning team. Here comes Bonner Maher. Flicking it forward, Stephen MacDonald stops him in his tracks. The ball is loose and available, but not anymore. And out over the end line and wide. First wide of the match for the Premier County.
Yeah, Bonner there, nice tip tap away there from Mark Ellis. And just looking here, I think it went off Bonner Maher's boot, and that's right, correct decision.
Lengthy puck out by Anthony Nash. Ball breaks free, Bill Cooper is there, so too is Harnedy. Three Tipperary defenders, one of them is Parik Maher. Comes eventually for his James Woodlock. He gives it for his Paddy Maher, who in turn tries to set up Kieran Bergen. Back there is Harnedy. Coming through the centre is Garrod Ryan. Available is Cahill Barrett, tries to scoop it up. Garrod Ryan is there. Did he touch it on the ground? He tried, I think, but got away with it. In comes Bill Cooper. Ball isn't loose and available. It's a bit of a mad scramble, to be honest with you. But it's intense. Here comes Paddy Maher, bursting forward. Referee still not giving a free, and it's out over the sideline. Barry Kelly indicates it. Free ball.
Yeah, it's all a bit manic early on, Marty. Both backlines well on top so far, mass defences, but you know, it will settle down. I think the early initial nerves are there, plain to be seen.
Sideline cut by Kieran Bergen. Mark Ellis. Good play by Cork, but the pass just went astray from Christopher Joyce. Gathered by James Woodlock. Two against two up here. Doing the hard work of Seamus Callanan. Rounding Shane O'Neill. Sends it across to Janet O'Wire. That was the intention, but the plan just didn't quite come off. But great work by Callanan. Here comes Shane McGrath. And the ball comes first. Callanan again. Hops it on the ground. He tries to make an angle. He's having a shot. Oh, my word! What a brilliant goal. Callanan has delivered in the biggest stage of them all. An All-Ireland semi-final in Croke Park.
Absolutely. Great work here by Shane McGrath. He covered a lot of ground to pick up that ball and he crossed it. And Seamus Callanan has been very prominent. See, Shane O'Neill dropped the ball out of his hand. Lovely touch there by Callanan. And all that was on his mind was a goal straight into the top corner. And another, you know, that won't do Shane O'Neill's confidence, and he got to drop a ball. Here it comes again.
Here come Tipperary. Is it a day when the six Tipperary forwards click, I wonder? This is Shane O'Neill. As Michael was saying, he'd be disappointed that he didn't get that first touch and would have prevented Callanan's goal. Comes far as Stephen McDonald into the centre. Great catch by Bill Cooper. Sends it down towards Lahan. Gathered instead by Kieran Bergen. Steps inside. Toddy Maher was looking for it. Delivers long. First option was the better one. But hindsight is a gift. And it's Tipperary again as Cork look a little bit rattled. James Woodlock makes a little bit of space. He's looking at the pulse. He's having a goal. And it's a good one. Seamus Callanan, a goal. James Woodlock, a point. Almost 7 minutes gone.
Yeah, and that's a great score by James Woodlock on the run from out the field. But again, I think Cork are doing an awful lot of short passing. Just watch the flick here off the ground by Seamus Callanan to regain control, and he just buried it in the roof of the net. A fantastic finish.
Now Cork, Munster champions. Obviously, the marker has been set down. Tipperary in business for Eamon O'Shea. He's been working steadily over the last number of weeks, making sure that his team are going to produce the performance of their lives. Darren Gleeson's puck out. Mark Ellis underneath it. Ball is available. Daniel Carney chinking away from Lark Corbett. Flicks it back. Steady as a rock, Cahill Barrett, under 21 player this year. It was very impressive in the Munster semi-final against Clare in Ennis at under 21 level. Shane McGrath sending it down towards John O'Dwyer, who looks dangerous. Noel McGrath laying it off as bubbles O'Dwyer, gets inside the cover, takes a shot, and that's over the bar. 1 point for James Woodlock, another one for John O'Dwyer, and that's a brilliant start by the Premier County.
It is, Martin. You have to say the Tipperary forwards look way sharper than the Cork forwards so far. Their movement is fantastic. Great ball in by Shane McGrath again, and Tipperary be delighted with this start.
7.5 minutes since Cork got the opening score off the stick of Alan Cadigan. Toddy Maher available at James Woodlock, who has to chase it. It's one against one up here. And it's Seamus Callanan and Mark Ellis is back there. Bonner Maher is hovering. The referee has blown his whistle. And he's judged that Seamus Callanan was fouling. And that is a free out for Cork.
Yeah, and if you look where Larry Corbett was there, he was 70 yards out the field. And they're creating that space inside, one on one. That's what they want to do, isolate Seamus Callanan in there.
Toddy Maher, magnificent catch. One against one. Far as James Woodlock, and again it's a testing ball for Callanan. He's underneath it, he gets a touch. Anthony Nash has to come off his line, no free given. Tipperary crowd might have been looking for one. Was Shane O'Neill fouling? I don't think so. Good play by Daniel Carney, giving it long. Carney is available. So too is Patrick Cronin. Has a shot from out the field, but it's wide of the target for Cork's second wide of the match.
Yeah, that's Tariq Maher. Brilliant in the air there. straight in over Bill Cooper. Great catch, and I think Tipperary management very unhappy with the one-on-ones inside on the square, the field that Seamus Callan had been dragged down there in the last. And here's another high ball in between them.
Here comes Shane McGrath, man on form. Again, the target is Callan, and again he gets a touch. O'Neill under a bit of pressure here. Bonner Maher is coming in to challenge. He manages to get a clearance. Far as Stephen McDonald. McDonald, the effort by John O'Dwyer doesn't quite connect. It's an easy ball for Lachlan McLaughlin. Giving it long. Oh, fantastic catch, Paddy Stapleton. And that is a free for Tipperary. Make no mistake about it, in the opening 10 minutes, the Premier County boys are on fire. The free is quickly taken. Bubbles does a little jig to the left, then hits it on the right, and Bubbles has scored his second point in Croke Park. It's a brilliant start by Tipperary.
Yeah, Marty, and you can see the way Tipperary want to play. That free was quickly taken by Páraic Maher. They just want to up the intensity, up the pace all the time. Another great score by John O'Dwyer, and Tipperary dominating this game.
It's a long time since Cork scored, over 10 minutes. Long ball, breaking ball, picked up by Aidan Walsh, and that is over the bar. A badly needed score by the Munster champions.
Yeah, and Aidan Walsh will need that. That's his first touch of the ball, I think. Good score, and Cork really needed a score now. They've really been dominated in the last 10 minutes.
Pinpoint, puck out from Darren Gleeson. Ends up with Brendan Maher. Referee felt there was a push on John O'Dwyer, and Stephen McDonald discussed the ins and outs of it, but ultimately James Owens is the man in charge, and it's a free for Tipperary. This is going to be taken just inside the Cork 45 metre line. They're waiting for a slither, that's the delay. But it gives us a chance to reprise the opening 12 minutes or so, Michael Dignan. Despite Alan Cadigan's first score of the game, Tipperary have been in control.
Absolutely, their half-back line has been very dominant. Kieran Bergen, Páraic Maher, Brendan Maher's in at centre-back, and their forwards are on fire. They're moving all over the place, and here's Callan taking the free. He's been central. They've been trying to isolate him on Shane O'Neill, and it's been, you know, every time the ball has gone in, it's created havoc.
Taps that over the bar. One Tipperary supporter very happy. Callanan.
We've seen this with Cork, Martin, before. They're notoriously slow starters. You know, last year against Clare, both days they fell behind, and they did it as well this year against Limerick. In the first 20 minutes, they were overrun by Limerick, but they came back into it. So it's early stages.
Took out his aimed at Seamus Harnaby. Coming through the middle is Conor Lahan. Being double marked at the moment by Tipperary. Ball into the centre is a good one. Here's Seamus Harnaby. Point on the offering, and he takes it. Cork beginning to find their rhythm after a rather slow start. Good vision here.
Yeah, absolutely. Lovely first touch by Harnaby as well. Lahan and Harnaby, great combination play, and again, a very good score.
Every puck out from Darren Gleeson, I have to say, impresses me. Every one of them accurate in the opening 13 minutes. Stephen McDonald. Damien Cahalan. Tony Maher playing in the half back line, going back to Gather. John O'Dwyer works hard, gathers the slither. Good defending by Cork. Damien Cahalan is there to sweep up. Tony Maher, his opposite number three, comes into challenge. Referee has blown his whistle. The linesman was indicating it was a Tipperary ball, but James Owens feels that there was a foul here.
Yeah, he fought, to me, he came in along there, all eyes on the ball, and I didn't see a lot wrong with that. Damien Cahalan was hooked actually from behind and lost control of it. So I think Cork lucky enough to win that free.
First opportunity of the semi-final for Patrick Horgan to take a free.
Not an easy one to start. Middle of the field on the sideline.
Of his 241, he scored one goal and 30 points for frees. This one has just gone to the left. The as you say, Michael, rather difficult one to start.
Absolutely. And there's been very, is that Seamus Callan has got one free, and that free, the game flown, and James Owens has let it go so far.
Puck out, comes straight to Kieran Bergen. James Woodlock waiting for Shane McGrath to deliver a high ball, and it's Seamus Callanan bearing down and goal. Waiting, Lar Corbett, difficult angle, and he drives it left and wide. He possibly had too much time, actually. He was looking around, and then he thought, okay, I'll have a go.
He was trying to slice it over. I thought, we might look at Callanan again. He's, you know, he really is doing very well in the air there. He has a huge height advantage over Shane O'Neill, and he's been very, very effective so far. Here's Lara now looking to slide it over the bar, and it just didn't work.
Puck out comes for Seamus Harnedy. Cody Ma gives it long to Lar Corbett. Target again is Seamus Callanan. Stephen McDonald with a new helmet. Black with a white stripe down the middle when you see him again. Here's Kyle Barrett. Keeping it long, Mark Ellis. Can't reach it, Shane O'Neill does. John O'Dwyer has it. Good block down by Daniel Carney. Having to help out his half-back line. Ball up for Patrick Corgan. Given a little bit of space on this occasion. He decides to have a go, which wasn't the right option, to be fair. I'm sure he realises that only too well.
Yeah, it was a poor wide. And I just feel the Cork forwards are, you know, hoping things will happen for them. They're not showing for the ball. Great hook there by Daniel Carney. He's been very prominent since the game started. But they're just sort of going for the ball a little bit half-hearted, I think. They're hoping to get a handy ball. You won't get that out there today. And a couple of their shots so far have been very poor as well.
Cork forwards, this time marking the Tipperary defenders, so Darren Gleeson having to go long with his puck out. Here comes Aidan Walsh. Ball inside. Oh, just about getting there was Dale Cooper, but again, the finish is poor. Five wides for Cork in this opening 17 minutes.
Yeah, and at least three of those, maybe four, have been really good chances. That really, you know, on another day would be over the bar. And but Cork getting more possession during the last 5 minutes. I think they've started to dominate possession around the middle of the field.
Seamus Harnedy getting on a quite amount of breaking ball again. Having a go from way out the field, and the end result is the same. They need to play it around a little bit and find Patrick Cronin and Patrick Horgan, and perhaps those two players with Alan Cadogan should go in deeper.
They should go in, maybe create a bit of space in front of them and show for the ball. I think the Tipperary backs are out in front every time, and there's very few options from out the field only to take that shot.
Great catch, wonderful fielding by Mark Ellis, easily blocked down subsequently. Ball into space, Brendan Maher is there, goes down that middle channel. Mark Ellis again doing well under a high ball, and he's dropping back a little bit deeper, I notice, trying to maybe go in front of Seamus Callanan and Shane O'Neill, because the long ball into Callanan is posing serious problems for Cork. The long ball here for Tipperary, or for Darren Gleeson, is easily dealt with. Referee, however, has blown his whistle, and I think he wants that to be retaken.
Yeah, he was writing something in his notebook, and you're right about Mark Ellis. He is he's doing very well so far on Bonnermar. He has drifted back a bit. He was following him out to field earlier, but he's now in there trying to protect Shane O'Neill as well. And here's the ball in.
Anthony Nash goes for the score, and that's over the bar. It's his second point of this championship journey. Good score by the goalkeeper.
Yeah, it indicates, I think, that the breeze might be slightly favouring Cork as well in this first half. That's a great strike by Anthony Nash when he got the second chance.
And just before that, Cork had shot four wides in 3 minutes. Again, the short puck out strategy working for Tipperary. Paddy Stapleton made himself available for Darren Gleeson. Sunshine is the problem here. Easily gathered by Aidan Walsh. Sends it into the middle. Sweeping across again is Paddy Maher. Over for Shane McGrath. Long ball again. They're hovering, but they don't have to hover because it's straight over the crossbar. Excellent play by Tipperary.
Yeah, great ball out there by Tariq Maher, and Shane McGrath right in the middle of the field, a beautiful strike. And Tipperary midfield, you know, I was saying maybe Cork had the advantage there, but Tipperary competing very, very well. Aidan Walsh has scored a point, and both the Tipperary midfielders and Daniel Kearney getting through a lot of work, so very open contest there so far.
And it's Shane McGrath again, appearing in his fourth championship match today for his county. He's now scored 26 points in his career. Far as Daniel Kearney, long ball up far as Horgan, goes on for as Alan Cadigan. Paddy Stapleton staying strong and firm and just conceding the 65, as Alan Cadigan, I think, seemed to be satisfied enough to get the 65.
Yeah, beautiful touch there by Shane McGrath. We've seen lots of that so far. You know, I think Cork are going to be happy enough. They really haven't got going, and they're, you know, this, if they can put this over the bar, they're only going to be 3 points down, having really not got into the game at all so far.
Might be sunny here at the moment, but dark clouds overhead, and watching in the stand, Brian Cody. Who will it be, Cork or Tipperary? Here's Patrick Horgan, second free. Disappointing, same result. Ball is wide, seventh wide of the match for Cork.
Yeah, that's unusual for him. Eddie Brennan mentioned before the match how important free taker, obviously at the top level, they're very important. And this short puck out again now.
It's working for Tipperary. Kieran Bergen then goes long, down towards Seamus Callanan, knocked away by Shane O'Neill. Lorcan McLaughlin, Daniel Kearney, Alan Cadigan, and he can't reach it. Sideline ball for Tipperary. But while that plan just didn't work there, Michael, that's the sort of ball that they need to be doing rather than shooting wildly and panicking.
Yeah, more direct hurling. I think we've seen a little bit more of it in the last few minutes, but you know, they were taking two and three passes to get the ball out of the defence, whereas a longer ball would give the forwards more time on the ball.
James Barry. Stays in, not any longer. Sideline ball for Tipperary again. Damien Cahalan conceding the sideline. This man can take sideline cuts. That's not his best either. Comes for us, James Woodlock. It was Noel McGrath, by the way, taking the sideline cut. And Woodlock makes the space, cuts through the middle. Available to his right, McGrath. He scored once. He's on the 45. He's going for it. And it's over the bar. Simple but effective. And good work by the two Tipperary midfielders. First Woodlock and then McGrath.
That's exactly what it was. You know, simple hurling, James Woodlock, good run, drew the man and unselfishly threw the ball out to Shane McGrath. And another great score from Tipperary, and moving very well around the middle of the field, half back line.
Oh, great catch by Brendan Marr. Toddy can do it, so too can Brendan. Marr's high feeling along that half back line. Really impressive. Look at the possessions, very tight, isn't it? Tipperary 51, Cork 49. Short ball again, Paddy Marr. Sending it down that middle channel towards Bonner Marr. Christopher Joyce is there, hand passes it back. Just about gets it far as Mark Ellis. He goes for distance. Bill Cooper and Conor Lahan are covering. Here comes Patrick Cronin. And it's across the face of the goal, and yet another wide for Cork. Eight wides. That statistic is beginning to, I'm sure, bother Cork supporters and Cork management.
Yeah, but that wasn't even a shot, really. It was just kind of a hit and hope, a bit of a lob across the square, and Jimmy Barry Murphy is going to be very disappointed with that type of shooting. It's, you know, just seemed to be lacking a bit of belief. The confidence level seemed to be dropping in the Cork forward line.
Again, the puck out is accurate. Finds Paddy Marr. Ball down the middle. Here comes Bonner. Trouble for Cork. Makes the space. Good defending, easily gathered by Anthony Nash. But the ball given away by Noel McGrath, and a great block by Bill Cooper. Cooper prevented a certain point. 10 out of 10 to the All-Back. Damien Callan and the Cork supporters, the Rebel supporters, are beginning to get behind the Munster champions. They want a little bit more fire in their bellies. Perhaps Harnedy can provide it. Pumps it into space. There's nobody home in a red jersey except Paddy Stapleton. Stops, blocks off Conor Lahan, and that's going to be a sideline ball for Tipperary.
Yeah, Tipper going to be, like, they're winning all the battles. They're hungrier. Great catch by Bonner Maher here. Heads for the goals like we've seen so many times. And it's going to be very disappointed. A weak shot at the end of it all. And Anthony Nash had lots of time to clear it. But, you know, Tipperary, even for the ball out, there was a couple of more hooks came in. They're blocking the Tip forwards. They're chasing and harrying. And we're not seeing that from the Cork forwards. I think they're behind their men nearly every time.
Sideline cut by Brendan Maher. Daniel Carney trying to get their head of Lar Corbett. Lar looks around, spots that Shane McGrath is available. Tipperary playing a nice possessive game, and this is Noel McGrath. I'm not too sure why he penalised Noel McGrath there, but it would appear perhaps he picked the ball off the ground on initial viewing. Let's just have a look at this. No.
Oh, lovely piece of skill, and
no, that shouldn't have been a free.
No, great piece of skill there. He got his hand under the ball, and James Owens only standing there looking down on top of it, so poor call.
Anthony Nash takes the free. Is it his second point of the game? It is. The goalkeeper is doing his job, not just saving at one end, but he scored twice. And at the moment, he's the top scorer for Cork.
That's a fantastic strike. You see the way he drew it in almost golf-like, and he's a long way out there. That was a great score, but, you know, it's a fairly bad day when you're depending on your goalie to keep you in the game. It scores.
Brendan Maher flicks it into the middle. Kieran Bergen. James Woodlock. Powerful. Going forward. Surely that was a foul by Daniel Carney. No free given. Here comes Lar Corbett, who wins the possession back. Diagonal ball is aimed at Seamus Callanan. Stephen MacDonald gives it back to his goalkeeper, who gives it everything. High dropping ball. Down towards Patrick Cronin. Wins the one against one with James Barry. Flicks it out for Conor Lahan. A point here would surely boost Cork belief, and indeed a huge, massive boost to their prospects. Conor Lahan, good score.
It was, and it was Route 1 hurling a hoosh up the field from Anthony Nash, and a mighty catch by Pat Cronin. And that's a bit of hunger that we haven't seen from Cork so far. Fantastic. I think James Woodlock went to ground very easy there. I think James Owens got that right.
Here comes Paddy Maher. Daniel Carney. Conor Lahan. Over for his Aidan Watt. Didn't get great power behind it. James Barry comes across to sweep up. Gets by Seamus Harnedy. Waiting for it is Shane McGrath. Bergen is available. In a right half back position. Noel McGrath, good play Tipperary. What about the finish? It's right and wide. And Seamus Callanan, I can see off camera, shouting at Noel McGrath to leave it in. Drop it in around the house.
Yeah, that supply line into Seamus Callanan has dried up in the last 10-15 minutes, and lovely play there out of defence, but Noel McGrath, normally very accurate from that distance, but put that one wide.
Wind assisted. It's a long, long puck out by Anthony Nash. Brendan Maher tussling. Sub two is Paddy Maher. Survives the challenge from Patrick Horgan. Then sends it down the right wing here. Coming across to Stephen MacDonald. Bonner Maher is with him. Bonner has no hurley. He has it now. MacDonald gives it for his Damien Callahan. Nice stick work by the St. Finbar's man. Over towards Patrick Cronin and leaves it behind him. James Barry turns and twists, gets in his clearance. John O'Dwyer is the only Tipperary man there. Seems to hit off a helmet, but Daniel Carney has come back into that left half-back position. Again, it's one against one here. Cronin did well the last time. He flicks it away. Brendan Maher is there. Sends it down. Better ball for Seamus Callanan to gather. Mark Ellis is there. Bonner Maher. Oh, beautiful hand pass back. Seamus Callanan is surely being fouled, or at least held back by Shane O'Neill, but Anthony Nash gathers it. Referee saw nothing, and the free, or rather the play, continues on with Larkin McLaughlin giving it long. Down for his Kieran Bergen, sweeping it down the middle. Plenty of Cork defenders. The call is from Mark Ellis. The handling is poor. Comes for his Lar Corbett, steps inside. Larkin McLaughlin still with it. Seamus Callanan hovering around the edge of the square. This is Callanan dropping it in, and it's an easy ball for Anthony Nash, who has the time and composure to spot and find Damien Callahan. Oh, great block down by John O'Dwyer. Carlisle was giving it everything. And John O'Dwyer blocks and punishes and scores in a beautiful piece of hurling. And look at the reaction of the Tipperary manager, Eamon O'Shea.
Great score by John O'Dwyer. He'd no right to get to that. Now, Damien Cahalan should have had the ball cleared. He took far too much time on it. But, you know, Martin, some of the hurling, it's basic. You know, we're driving balls up the middle. Cork are panicking now, going with this high ball every time.
Conor Lahan splits the post. Good play by Cork.
It was a lovely touchdown there. And Conor Lahan, look how quick he struck that ball. A beautiful score. And Cork, as I've said already, hanging in there with Tipperary having loads of the play. Here's Seamus Callan. I didn't see a foul there. I thought Shane O'Neill was going for the ball.
Tony Marr gathers just inside his own 65. It's two against two here. Here comes Lahan. Oh, he left it behind him. And in comes Christopher Joyce. A rare mistake by Lara Corbett. And Christopher Joyce in quickly to relieve the pressure. And Cork fans relieved. And again, it's a terrible waste of possession by Cork. Nine wides, this time off the stick of Aidan Walsh.
Yeah, that was terrible. Daniel Kearney had made a great run. Here we are now, Lara Corbett. All he's do is pick it and bury it, imagine. Just a little bit casual and ran over the ball. And Christopher Joyce comes in and gets the clearance away. And then we saw Aidan Walsh, the next ball. Daniel Kearney made a great run beside him. All he had to do was flick it on, and he went for a shot from way out the field and poked it wide again.
Daniel Kearney pulling on the ball as James Woodlock. Bonner Marr steps away from the challenge. Hot pursuit is the opposite number 11, Bill Cooper. Stephen McDonald is the number 4. Here's Bill Cooper again, doing a lot of the hard work, grafting. That's a better ball up towards Alan Cadigan, gathered by Kieran Bergen. And he clears it. Shane O'Neill is there, getting there ahead of Seamus Callanan. It's a poor hand pass. Comes back to O'Neill. This time he connects. Two against two up here. James Barry, Patrick Cronin, three defenders. Paddy Maher is back there. Turns onto his left, as you can see, and drives it down the field. Great hands, great catch. Seamus Harnedy trying to get through the challenge. Good defending by Tipperary. And the referee gives a free to Seamus Harnedy and to Cork, and the Tipperary players protest with a certain amount of justification, I would suspect.
Yeah, I think so. Here you see a great catch by Harnedy. The referee has brought it forward now, but he goes through. Ball is flicked away. He loses possession. I don't see any free there. And I think that's another harsh call. And Tipperary very unhappy with a number of decisions down the first half.
Brendan Maher, the Tipperary captain, explaining his frustration with that particular decision. And there's dissent. And there's an extra 30
Marty,
meters.
We saw something very similar last week. Limerick dominated possession, you know, and dominated the play against Kilkenny, but Kilkenny got a goal before half-time, and we're going to see Cork now reducing the gap to 2 points, with Tipperary have been obviously the clearly more dominant team in the first half so far.
Patrick Hogan, third free of the match, first point of the game. And despite being outplayed, and certainly even from a strategic point of view, Tipperary have been winning that battle along the sideline. Tipperary only leading by 2 points.
Yeah, but you know, you have to say as well, Cork, after hitting a lot of wides as well, they have got a lot more possession. They started poorly, but since then they've got a lot more possession around the midfield, and their backs have come to grips with Tipperary.
Noel McGrath's long ball comes down for Stephen McDonald. Mark Ellis is back there to lend assistance. Goes for distance. Patrick Horgan, brilliant catch over Kyle Barrett's head. And the referee has given a free to Tipperary, and he's indicated that Patrick Horgan took too many steps. I find that difficult to believe.
It's a balancing act, I think, there. The last free shouldn't have been a free. I think that should have been a free. What a catch here by Patrick Horgan. He's trying to play the ball, he's heading for the goals, and he's held up.
Surely that should have been a free in.
Absolutely. And a few strange decisions there now in the last couple of minutes.
Free by Darren Gleeson. Crucial time in this All-Ireland semi-final. 1 minute of additional time at least going to be played. Paddy Stapleton's hurley being held by Alan Cadigan. This time the decision is absolutely correct. Bill Cooper and James Woodlock get to know each other a little bit more than normal.
And Alan Callaghan just a bit casual again, as I mentioned earlier. He didn't get down and cover that ball. You know, he just got one hand to it and left the room for Paddy Staples beside and put in the tackle. And you can see him holding the hurler. Good call there.
John O'Dwyer. What a beautiful spot called Killinall. Taking the free. Seth and Noel McGrath play a 1-2. John O'Dwyer hits this very much to the right and wide. It's only Tipperary's fourth wide of the game, by the way. And in contrast, Cork have hit 9.
A lot of speculation about a huge shootout. I think Eddie Brennan urging caution beforehand in the studio. He felt it was going to be a tight game, and you know, there's a lot of mistakes. It's error-ridden, and we haven't got the open game we hope for.
Ball drops down towards Shane McGrath. Shane O'Neill. Nobody to challenge him. Goes long by Patrick Cronin. Better from Cork. Alan Cadigan. And the Munster champions do something before half time. Tipperary defensively look very strong. Paddy Stapleton. There's James Woodlock. 4 against 2 up here. 4 being 4 Cork defenders. Damien Callahan gets it. There's Daniel Carney, and the referee blows the half-time whistle. A spectacular goal after 5 minutes by Seamus Callanan. And really, Shane O'Neill should have cut it out, but Callanan punished the error, and he hit a rasper into the back of the Cork net. Sides have never been level in this opening half. There have been no yellow cards, no red cards. And at half-time, it's Tipperary beating the Munster champions Cork on a scoreline of Tipperary 1-7. Cork 8 points. Join us after the break for Gerlach Nairn, Cyril Farrell and Eddie Brennan for their thoughts with Michael.
Maribor in the Champions League playoff stage first leg. Wednesday at 7:30 on RTE2 and RTE2 HD.
The UEFA Champions League programme on Wednesday will be brought to you by Nissan and MasterCard, UEFA Champions League sponsors.
In life, you cannot always choose what you do, but you can always choose who you are. We are the Sappers. With every brace and every cufflink, we say, I am the master of my fate. I am the captain of my soul.
There's no better time to explore life's journeys than Heritage Week. Discover hundreds of events at heritageweek.ie or pick up a guide in your local library or tourism office. National Heritage Week runs from August 23rd to 31st. Coordinated by the Heritage Council.
This number is incredible, because with it, you can switch to Aircom's lowest price bundles ever with outstanding super fast fibre broadband and home phone for only €24 a month. Or, for the same fantastic price, you could add TV or, if you prefer, mobile. Unbelievably, you can even choose to get all four, still for only €24. Only Aircom can bring you a TV bundle for €24, a mobile bundle for €24, or the total bundle for €24 a month for the first 6 months. To choose your bundle, just call 1-800-303-433.
Let me break your world of flow. Go along. squashed. The great taste of Robinson's set free.
Good drivers know you need to take the road seriously, and for that they deserve a reward.
Introducing the Drive Safer Reward from Liberty Insurance. If you've got 5 or more years no claims bonus on your fully comprehensive car insurance, we promise to cut 60% off your premium. And if you've got no penalty points, we'll cut another 28% off whatever's left. We want to help make the road safer and save you money too. So call us today. Liberty Insurance. Car, home or van. It's insurance the way it should be.
We have reached the halfway stage in this All-Ireland Hurling semi-final between Cork and Tipperary. And as it stands, it is Tipperary, and they lead by 1 goal and 7 points to 9 points. Well, that's a quick look at the stats from this match. As you can see, Cork have actually created just slightly more scoring chances than their opponents in that game, but significantly, Cork have also hit twice as many wides as their opponents. That has been a feature of that first half. Will they regret that by the end of the game? Gerard Nan, Eddie Brennan, Cyril Farrell have been enjoying that first half here with us. Eddie, you made a comment to me there a moment ago saying there's high-risk hurling being played by both teams here. Explain that to me.
Yeah, there's. You'd have to say there's a lot of, even stuff that you'd associate, no disrespect to junior hurling, lads standing up and trying to hit it this level you do not get a second to breathe, and particularly out there today, it's that kind of a match. There's so much at stake, it's high intensity, but you'd have to say there was a lot of mistakes around the goal. I mean, one was punished very hard for Shane O'Neill, unfortunately, but there has been a few close calls on both sides as well. Tipper willing to play the ball out of defence here, and you'd have to say that Darren Gleeson is finding his men. But on a few occasions, there has would-be blocks have been very, very close. And if you get one of them in front of the goal, it could be the defining moment. But it's probably down to the occasion. You know, you'd say that both teams look a little bit nervous. A lot of the stuff is down the middle. Tip off to a flyer, and Cork have steadied up.
Ger, it's an absorbing game, but it is a kind of a strange game at the same time.
It is very, very strange, Michael, because first of all, it's not the shootout that we all expected. You know, that's...
I said that's probably
exactly. We were saying that wouldn't happen because it's so expected. Both teams almost playing with a sweeper, definitely a man back. I suppose Cork not an official sweeper, really. Daniel Carney going back into centre back, and Ellis then covering the space in front of goal. No, I think Cork have made a massive boo-boo with our matchups, with O'Neill at fullback. We know the problems he had here last year against Shane O'Donnell when exposing his own inside. And Stephen McDonald, now their best fullback line defender, is out wing-back on Bubbles of the Wire. He started there, he has moved back now, but he started there. So that really weakened our fullback line, and Tip really attacked that fullback line.
Big time.
They really targeted that fullback line, and it paid huge dividends for them.
Well, they did. They got the goals, Earl.
Yeah, but even though attacked, and I know they got the goal early on. Like this goal probably should. Like, he's very good in there, Cannon. But like, a lot of ball has been broken as well. Shamie Cannon here has to look up now. He's only one thing of mine. It'll flick across here, like beautiful ball across. You know, it's still not done. Shamie McGrath, who's a great midfielder, gets this ball, wins a hard ball. Now he goes up along the touchline here, has a look across and drills it across. Shane O'Neill comes through and actually misses it. So it breaks to Cannon. I thought Cannon was going to come out tapped over the bar. There's only one thing you go for here, back at the net. He picks the only spot that's available. There's a lot of
He's a scoring man this summer.
McGrath has done a good bit of running, and O'Neill probably misses the
and
ball.
This is it, because if you were a full back or as a forward, there'd be lads cursing you saying, why aren't you up with the play? Shane O'Neill looks like it's going to be bread and butter, and he just laps in concentration for a split second. And I know, because I've been that forward that stands out there and you get criticised for that. But you look at it here, when Callan gets it, he just looks up. Again, goalkeeper is blinded by his defenders. Lovely little area for Callan to aim at, and no better fella. It looks as if the chance has gone from him. I mean, when it broke first, but you'd have to say, great composure, great confidence to bang that into the top corner. But Anthony Nash impeded by his two defenders.
He was. I mentioned the stat there, Ger. A moment ago, Cork twice as many wides as Tipperary. Some of those wides, was it because they were shooting under pressure, do you think, or what was the...
Well, I thought one of the reasons for a lot of the wides was when the man got the ball around the middle of the field, he was left with no option inside because the whole full forward line had come out so far. But somebody, like Pat Hogan, is having a nightmare. He's having a nightmare game from freeze and from play. You know, he has put two very scoreable frees wide, yeah. put a 65 wide. Aidan Walsh here again, you know. Now he looks up and inside, look at the space inside. There's nobody inside to let the ball into. So really you have to shoot from distance when the option isn't there. But, you know, Cork seem nervous, don't they? They lack the sharpness that they had in Munster. Maybe it's the long layoff, the 5 weeks layoff, and maybe it's the typical Cork start to the game, which is a slower start anyway. Now they have come into the game, like by the 15th minute they had shot seven wides, like, you know, and then they shot four in a row. Wides in a row, which is very dispiriting. But you know, typical Cork, they still came back into the game again, won a few frees, got another point to play, and are only 2 points down at half time. So, really, you'll be saying, this is a typical Cork display we have seen this year. Slow start, gradually come into the game. The thing is now, can they push it on in the second half?
Tip lead, they're halfway there. Can they drive on now and reach this year's All Ireland hurling final? The second half is coming up after the break.
Centra, sponsors of the GAA Hurling Championship. You discovered Molson Canadian yet? Find out for yourself why it's one of Canada's favorites. Your beer, make it Canadian.
It was all pretty simple.
One call. No, listen, Matt. If you want to get insurance, you take the day off work and you top up the motor and ring them up. Get the best quote. Then you ring them back later on. Why? Different person, different quote. Then ring back in a different voice. Why? Then different quote.
Nonsense.
Cut the nonsense! Make one call to No Nonsense and choose ReadyMade, the low-cost comprehensive car insurance package.
Thanks, No Nonsense. You're the best.
Get low-cost car insurance with No Nonsense.
Kieran, what kind of life do you have?
I've got to live for Friday night. Need to move out of my parents' house kind of life.
Can't you online? I've got a modern kind of life.
Need to know everything, need all the facts kind of life.
Going steady kind of life.
Highly competitive.
We need to go.
I know, just give me a minute. I'm
free living, free this evening kind of life.
Tight budgets, tight belts.
Ah, she's shopping online. Met my boyfriend online.
I'm in love kind of life.
Split up with him online.
I just need extra space in my life for cats, dogs, rabbits, kids, husband.
I've got a hectic kind of
free this evening kind of
get my own place kind of
I've got a modern kind of
cautious kind of
it's my kind of life.
Your kind of bank for your kind of life.
Some moments teach you all you need to know about yourself. The Electric Ireland GAA Minor Championships. This is Major.
Football semi-final.
Ah, yes, next week the attention turns to the big ball game, Kerry versus Mayo, in their All-Ireland football semi-final here on RTE. And the build-up begins on Friday with our magazine programme. It's Friday, that's at 8:30 on RTE2. By the way, it's also available on the RTE player. All right, then it's half-time in this hurling semi-final. Tipperary leading Cork by 1 goal and 7 points to 8 points in front of an attendance of 68,728. And as Cyril Farrell put it, that's a savage crowd.
Yeah, it's unreal for this time of the year. Like, 70,000 for the semi-final.
Oh, it's brilliant.
It's a very exciting game. Jim Barry Murphy was still happy enough at halftime, Michael, because I know the boys saying they're missing chances, but they are getting the chances. And their record all year is the second half. Usually these starts could start going over the bar. Whereas Tip have got goal chances, haven't taken them, and Cork are still in the game, even though not hurling well.
Oh, they are. There's only 2 points in it, which is nothing in hurling. No. We spoke before the match, Ger, about it can be one of those days when one player puts his mark on the game and makes a difference. Now, in the first half for me, that was John O'Dwyer, because he scored 3 points in play in a game that hasn't been, as we said, producing free-flowing scoring.
Yeah, we spoke before the game about the danger of the Tipperary forwards, but four of the forwards haven't scored for play, and only and only one has got points in play, and that's John O'Dwyer here, Bubbles O'Dwyer. Now, some of that interplay is very, very good, but the thing about Bubbles is he has that wrist, you know, left and right. Yeah. He has such great wrist left and right, and he crosses across that half-forward line. 1 minute he's right half-forward, the next minute he's left half-forward. Now, the third of the points he's got, this is inexcusable, really, for a defender in top-class level here, coming out of the ball, Amy Callahan, for being hooked from a mile away and ball over the bar. One look is all he needs to put the ball over the bar. You know, I suppose one of the things that's about Cork is that the two footballers, Callahan and Walsh, are really struggling with that striking, you know, under pressure especially. You know, those two are really struggling. McGrath's having a great game at midfield. Conor O'Sullivan, I'm so surprised that Conor O'Sullivan isn't coming into that team with his level of skill, especially in a day like today.
So from last year, we're talking about Bubbles there, very same as Conor Lehan, both all wristy hurlers and score from either side.
All right, lads, the teams are back, so let's head to the commentary box again to Michael Dagnan and Marty Morrissey.
Thank you very much, Michael. No changes on either side. James Woodlock having a long conversation with James Owens there and perhaps discussing some of the decisions of the first half. But either way, it's all to play for. A place in the All-Ireland Hurling Final on September 7th. Kilkenny waiting in the wings for what will undoubtedly be a wonderful day. Seamus Callanan intercepted beautifully by Shane O'Neill, subsequently hooked by Noel McGrath. Cork, as we're saying at half-time, are usually a better second-half team. Well, they have to produce it, as Daniel Carney's effort goes to the left and wide, reaching the number 10 in terms of wides shot in this All-Ireland semi-final by Cork.
Yeah, looking around, Noel McGrath looks to be gone in centre-half forward now with Bonner Maher out in the wing, and again there, that was a decent chance again by Daniel Carney and poked it wide.
Conor Lahad flicking it up for Zayden Walsh, who returns the compliment. James Woodlock is backtracking. Again, the short passing game by Cork. Aidan Walsh, no ground gained. Ball for Bill Cooper to Gavin. Rebound suits him, but he's able to get the hand pass back. Three Tipperary players around him. Noel McGrath's one. Shane O'Neill doing well, attacking the ball, coming forward under pressure from Seamus Callanan. Callanan received a knock there, just an accidental collision. Aidan Walsh comes away with it, but the referee has blown his whistle, and he's allowing Seamus Callanan to get some medical attention.
Well, I'm sure Cork spent a lot of half time talking about getting the ball in more direct. Here you just see an accidental clash. Aidan Walsh came in and hit Seamus Callanan, and you know, straight away in the second half, three passes across the half forward line there. It's a heavy knock there.
He's a warrior, he's a great hurler, he's had a wonderful championship campaign up to now. All-Ireland minor medalist in 2006, he scored the winning point against Kilkenny actually in the semi-final. Today is his 28th championship appearance, and often criticised because he didn't produce it in Croke Park, but he's doing well here.
Doing well, and this option now, Cork had to free to restart, but can't score direct from it, so.
Anthony Nash, as Aidan Walsh, the two Kentuck boys. Good work here by Brendan Maher. Good work here by Lorcan McLaughlin. Coming across is Tony Maher, but Schlitter dribbles over the sideline. Sideline ball for Tipperary. It's a swirling breeze actually here in Croke Park. You look at the flags on the hillside, they're going from left to right. And on the pitch, they seem to be favouring Cork in the second half. Sideline cut is not a great one, but it still works out for Gerard Ryan. Long ball. Beautifully gathered. It's Bonner Maher who flicks it in. The danger for Cork. And Lara Corbett was hovering. As a hurling gone flying through the air, Christopher Joyce gets it out for his Stephen McDonald. Here comes Bill Cooper, knocked away by Shane McGrath. In comes Gerard Ryan. McGrath calls for it. He looks, he's already scored twice. And this is going all the way. Wonderful play by Tipperary, and in particular Shane McGrath. He's a man very much on form.
Yeah, that's a great score from way out the field. Good work by Gerard Ryan. And before that, we saw great control here by Bonner Maher again, headed for the goals and picked out Lara. But great covering there by Mark Ellis. He covered back from the centre half back position and cut off a certain goal.
Patrick Horgan being marked tightly by Carl Barrett. James Woodlock is there. It's Horgan that has it. Daniel Carney was calling for it. Horgan drops it in. Patrick Cronin is underneath it. Tries to put up the big hand. Darren Gleeson is there. A little bit of indecision between Gleeson and Barry, but Darren Gleeson takes control. Sends it out over the sideline. Line ball for Cork.
Yeah. Darren Gleeson did well. He just got up happy enough just to clear it anywhere out over the line. And he'll be arriving back in here. Aidan Walsh, normally pretty good at these line balls. Just waiting for the game to get going, Marty. You know, it's just stuttering along, not much happening, and you know, we need something maybe to spark it into life.
Aidan Walsh's sideline cut is a good one, but it's inaccurate, I'm afraid. Ball is wide. Young Footballer of the Year back in 2010. Here's the sideline cut. Got right underneath it, but
yeah, we have this debate every time we go to a match. You know, should you go for them or drop them in? And when they go over, they look great, but a lot of the time, especially in this sort of game, where Cork are struggling to get into it, they could do with that dropping in around the square.
Still only Seamus Callanan's goal separating the teams. The clock under a little bit of pressure, severe pressure in fact. Backfire Stephen McDonald, who's back to his normal red and green helmets. Brendan Maher. Cody Maher. Maher combination. Anthony Nash. In control. Over for his Napier Sheik's Christopher Joyce. Bill Cooper. Available. High ball for Patrick Cronin. Sweeping up is Paul Barrett. Good defending by the right corner back. Gets it out first, Paddy Maher. About to be challenged by Bill Cooper. Still Paddy. Perlis man. Cool under pressure. James Woodlock. And that is going straight between the posts. Between them, McGrath and Woodlock at midfield for Tipperary. They've now scored 5 points from play.
They have, and the prediction I made before the match was that the Cork midfield would dominate, but it's completely the opposite. I thought that Carney and Walsh in the form they're in would dominate that midfield, but the Tipperary midfielders have been absolutely brilliant. There's high tack, Pat Horgan coming in there a bit high. Cathal Barrett is sweeping up very well. He's having a brilliant game for Tip.
Out of Tipperary's 1-9, one goal and 8 points come from play, and they're coming looking for scores again. Over for his Bonner Maher, Damien Cahalan, it's Lara Corbett. Looking around for support. Available is Seamus Callanan going for a second point of the game. And it's over the bar again. They've often said in Tipperary that if the six Tipperary forwards ever clicked on a particular day, they would cause havoc for any opposition. It's pretty close to it at the moment. They're dominating so many areas.
Yeah, their interplay is fantastic. They're playing as a team. You know, their first every ball. Brendan Maher started that with a brilliant catch at halfback. And they're just completely dominating this game.
Kieran Berger, ball given away. Daniel Carney. Nipping in is Carl Barrett. Did well, survived the hefty challenge. Good stick work by the corner back from Holy Cross Ballycal. Stephen McDonald, situation under control to allow Mark Ellis to sweep it up. Send it down towards Seamus Harnaby with Brendan Maher. Again, Tipperary are somewhat to control their double marking here with Harnedy into the centre to Aidan Walsh. Under pressure, it's dropping and it's going to the left and wide again. It's now a dozen wides for Cork, and the shooting, okay, they're getting the chances, but some of the decision making is poor, isn't it, Michael?
It is, and there's an awful lot of passes. There you see Brendan Maher again, what a fantastic catch. But you know, the Tipperary half back line, they're dominating, they're pacey, they're getting to the ball first, and a lot of the Cork shooting, you know, it's not decisive. They're just lobbing the ball and hoping that it goes over the bar.
Mark Ellis gets a touch. Picking up the loose ball is Noel McGrath. He hits it wide. It's 11 minutes since Cork scored.
Yeah, Noel McGrath hasn't scored. That's two good chances. Lara Corbett hasn't scored. Garrod Ryan, Bonner Maher hasn't scored, you know. So it's not that the Tipperary forwards are on fire right around the scoreboard, but they're just keeping ahead and they're looking very comfortable.
Brendan Maher was surely fouled as that ball was dropping down. Seemed to have been held there momentarily. Referee gives the sideline ball to Maher. Look what's happening along the sideline. Double substitution coming Cork's way. Audie O'Sullivan has scored the second goal in the Munster hurling final. Is going to be introduced with Stephen Moylan. As Cork acknowledged, they're in trouble here. Paddy Maher steps away from the challenge. Bonner Maher is hovering, trying to get a ball back out for his Seamus Callanan. Three against two. Good play by Cork on this occasion from Mark Ellis. Gets it down for his Aidan Walsh, a little bit of space. Alan Cadigan showed well, beats Paddy Stapleton on this occasion. Cadigan fouled as he was going through, and that's a free from Cork. And a little bit more fire from Cork, and that sort of play from Alan Cadigan will surely give a little bit of hope to his colleagues and inspire them.
Yeah, fantastic catch there. And, you know, yeah, that's it. They have to hang in there. He looks to be hurt. He's... Watch here when Brendan Maher came in on top of him. It's a great catch, first of all. But, you know, that was a better ball in by Aidan Walsh. And Cork are still in this game. There's only going to be 4 points in it after this free is scored. The ref, I think, booking Paddy Stapleton here now after that tackle. And it's not over yet. You're just waiting for Cork to spark into life. And Tipperary, while they've been dominating, they haven't put Cork away either.
Alan Cadigan is going to be replaced. Coming on is Paddy O'Sullivan, younger brother of Dermot Rock O'Sullivan, of course. So he comes in. Being introduced is Stephen Moylan from the Douglas Club. He's coming in instead of Patrick Cronin. So Cork changing. Two players in the full forward line. I'm hoping for a change of fortune and perhaps a change in strategy as well. Puck out from Darren Gleeson to Paddy Maher. Bonner Maher to Sewell. Hard pull by Bonner Maher. Referee has blown his whistle immediately. And he wants to have a word with the Tipperary centre half forwards. This looks like it's going to be a yellow card. It is.
Yeah, Bonner Maher, normally tough player. This looked a wild pull. And, long, you know, that's... Watch it here now. He's down on the ball. He's, you know, it looked worse than it was. And he's no more than the yellow card.
Goalkeeper Darren Gleeson gathers. Fed Paddy Maher. Well won by Noel McGrath. Flicks it into the centre. Parker backtracking. Lorcan McLaughlin is there. In comes Aidan Walsh. It comes through. With his second goal of the game, and Eamon O'Shea knows now there is a light in the tunnel and there's a place in the All-Ireland hurling final. Cork should have dealt with this. Bonner Maher, Garrod Ryan never gave up. It was Bonner that gave the pass over for Seamus Callanan, and Callanan let fly. Munster champions in trouble. Deep trouble. Here comes Patrick Hogan. Great defending by Cathal Barrett. And the free is for Tipperary. And Tipperary are on fire.
Yeah, absolutely. And here's Pat Horgan coming through. Cathal Barrett comes back. Great tackle. He's been absolutely outstanding. He's upended then by Pat Horgan. But here's the goal. Just watch Bonner Maher again. Just after yellow card, he's looking one way, passes the other, and Seamus Callan, an absolutely phenomenal finish to the roof of the net again. Just look at the follow through and the power that he puts into that. Anthony Nash, no chance.
Tuck out. It was a lengthy one, easily gathered by Christopher Joyce. Paddy Maher comes across to gather and calls. Excellent, yeah. James Woodlock. Slipping one through. It's to Callanan. Here's the hat trick. Oh, he just took his eye off it. He was about to pull the trigger, and he just took his eye off it momentarily, and Cork are relieved. The fullback problem for Cork has come back to haunt them. Here comes Kieran Bergen. Into the centre to Noel McGrath. From outside the 45-metre line, it's his first point in this All-Ireland semi-final.
Yeah, fantastic score there. Great work by Kieran Bergen again. And you'd have to say that the foundation has been set down here by the Tipperary half-back line. They've been absolutely immense. Pádraig Maher has given an exhibition of hurling out there. Great catch for the last ball there, and brilliant delivery inside. And the half-back line and Cathal Barrett have been brilliant so far.
Aidan Walsh. Daniel Carney in a little bit of space, pulls the brakes and tries to turn right, but runs into a cul-de-sac of Tipperary jerseys. Good block down. Paddy Maher is a mix in the half back line. Look at Paddy Maher. Noel McGrath takes up the responsibility, hits the slither left and wide. Just as you mentioned about the half back line dominating, look at that from Paddy Maher. The puck out is quickly taken. Lorcan McLaughlin down towards Conor Lahan, chasing Brendan Maher. Daniel Carney, nothing going right for Carney. Chance here to make amends. Sends this in, and it's right and wide. And again, I notice off camera Paddy O'Sullivan and the others in the full forward line there saying, let the ball in.
Yeah, they're getting very little delivery inside. But if you look at the Munster final, Cork half forward line, once they settled into the game, they were on fire. They destroyed the Limerick half back line with pure pace and power. But that to Tipperary today. Tipperary are outpacing them. They're going to the ball. Brendan Maher, Pádraig Maher, Kieran Bergen, absolutely outstanding. And Pádraig Maher has managed to sweep back in front of the full back line and get up the field and catch puck outs. And he just seems to be everywhere. And I think he's down injured there at the moment as well.
Ronnie Maher, captain of the Tipperary under 21 team back in 2010, they won the All-Ireland. The ball is slipped down towards Bonner Maher, flicking one forward first, John O'Dowar, and that's over the bar. It's his fourth point of the game. He really is impressive, all of them from play. And whatever vantage point you have in Croke Park, and if you're from Tipperary, you're pretty happy at the moment.
And it's Bonner Maher again, Marty. You know, he's just his ability to win ball and distribute it quickly. Great running by John O'Dwyer, 4 points from play, and he's having a fantastic season. Another great game today.
16 minutes into the second half. Cork have only managed 1 point in this second period. Great run here by Lahan, and that is over the bar. And that statistic had to be changed rather rapidly. But it's still only Cork's second point of the match in the second half.
Yeah, it's a brilliant score though. He picked it up a long way out the field and showed his pace, and Kieran Bergen stayed with him, but he's still off the hurl. Beautiful flicking over the barrier. And you know, it's still 20 minutes to go, and you know, if Cork could get a goal, to be bring them back into the game.
Tuck out accuracy from Darren Gleeson is one of the features of this match. Slither bubbles all the way for Seamus Callanan to John O'Dowar. And they are some duet, these two boys. Callanan feeds O'Dowar, and John bubbles O'Dowar, gets his fifth point of the game.
And when you have a forward line willing to throw the ball around, it makes them very, very hard to mark. When there's no, you know, there's no greediness within that forward line, they're all willing to play for each other, they're unselfish. And you know, Seamus Callanan, a lovely pass out, and John O'Dowar again over the bar.
Ball comes down for us, Cathal Barrett. He's played well on Patrick Corgan. Here comes Bill Cooper, chance of a goal, it puts him into the center, a beautiful interception by James Barry. A goal written all over it. And Tipperary are back there now in numbers. Kieran Berger. Over for Oscar Roldwyn. Long ball. Again for Shane. Lara Corbett is available to his right. Helen flicks it to a player that's available who's doing this for fun. It's John, bubbles on the wire. 6 points, the left half forward has scored. But again, it's Callanan flicking it up, feeding on the wire, point.
Yeah, but he's making it look so easy. Great work by Seamus Callanan, as you say. Could have been a goal at the other end. Great interception here by James Barry. Kept his eye on the ball all the way. Eventually made its way up the field. Garrod Ryan moves that ball so quickly into Seamus Callanan. A great score.
Eden Walsh. Again, they're blocking, they're hooking. Tipperary are working so hard. Garrod Ryan. Fantastic catch by Bonama. And has the composure to spot Noel McGrath available. Swings it back across the face of the goal again. This is James Woodlock. Gets it at the second attempt. Woodlock. Getting by Daniel Carney. Still Woodlock. Uses the short grip and flicks it over the bar for his third point of the game. The two Tipperary midfielders have now scored 3 points apiece.
Yeah, and I think that typifies the spirit of Tipperary. James Woodlock back from a serious leg injury over the last couple of years, hung in there. Look at Bonner Maher again with a fantastic catch. James Woodlock's performance is full of honesty, and here's Aidan Walsh now been taken off. Had a very tough afternoon, and Tipperary midfield have been absolutely brilliant, have dominated the game.
Rob O'Shea is on for Aidan Walsh, another one of the Cork under-21s. Played well in the Munster final against Clare, but he's more of a forward than anything else. And here he is, dropping the ball in. Here's Claudio Sullivan. Darren Gleeson is in control. Sweeps it down towards Garrod Ryan. Conor Lahan is there, so too is Rob O'Shea. Stephen Boylan. Nice ball inside for Conor Lahan. Goal must be on his mind. Here's the shot! And Darren Gleeson saves and deflects it over the bar for Conor Lahan's 4 point. But credit to Tipperary keeper with a fine save.
Yeah, Conor Lahan is, you know, staying, trying. Great save by Darren Gleeson off the post and over the bar. Lahan really the only Cork forward now that's, you know, shown a bit of fight, and Tipperary have put this game, I think, outside of Cork's reach at this stage.
Well, out of their 2 goals and 15 points, here's an interesting statistic. Tipperary have scored 2-14 from play, only 1 point from a free. And that scored by Seamus Callanan, who's now in a personal tally of 2-2 in this All-Ireland semi-final. James Barry. John O'Dwyer. Conor Maher is outside him. John O'Dwyer this time went for the score, but when you've scored 6 times, I suppose your confidence is high.
You're entitled to have a go, I think, at that stage.
This is Dennis Marr. He's played a prominent role in all of the Tipperary games this summer. So Dennis Marr from Curtis Harskills is on. The road line is the one that's called ashore.
Yeah, but he's done well. I think Garrod Ryan has done his job. He moves that ball very, very quickly into his full forward line when he gets it, and he played a part in a lot of scores out there today.
James Woodland. Shane O'Neill read the situation well. Stephen McDonald. Daniel Carney gives it plenty of air. Here comes Paddy O'Sullivan. Goal it has to be. It's the side netting. Darren Gleeson had the situation covered anyway.
Yeah, the ball was left hanging on there. Paddy O'Sullivan, as usual, very sharp. So he meant to put it over into the other corner and just into the side net and wide. I think a very significant move, Marty, at half-time was Bonner Maher was moved in corner forward, in on Stephen McDonald, maybe two-man full forward with Seamus Callanan. He's caused absolute havoc in there since half-time. He's created an awful lot of chances, and he's been very significant.
Rob O'Shea to Bill Cooper. It's goals they're trying to create now. Claudio Sullivan trying to give it back to centre half forward. Look look at the way Tipperary have been chasing and harassing. This time the ball rebounds into the path of Rob O'Shea. Good vision to spot Conor Lahan available. There's nobody really outside Lahan. Dropping this one in, trying to create another opportunity of a... Paddy O'Sullivan was about to give it loads, but didn't quite connect. Shane McGrath goes for the long ball. Seamus Callanan is down injured again. Seems to be a high injury. Conor Maher, meanwhile, is going through. Two Cork defenders around him still. Conor Maher is inside the large rectangle, trying to get a shot in. Good defending by Cork on this occasion. Meanwhile, Seamus Callanan gets some medical attention, and Cork tried to relieve the pressure, but the ball is given away to James Woodlock. Noel McGrath from out the field, and again, the ball is wide. Where we have had 8 wides in this match.
That's Noel McGrath's 3rd wide, I think, and not like him, but he had a few. And here's Owen Kelly, the great Owen Kelly, warming up, the man who stuck it in there with Tipperary, I suppose, over the last year or 18 months. He hasn't been getting any starts, but what a man to have around the dressing room for the younger players coming through. A fantastic player, great leader, and we're going to see him introduced shortly.
Well, Eamon O'Shea has always said that he felt, one, that there were really playing well in training but not producing it and performing on the day. Only occasionally James Woodlock said it with me during an interview during the week, but it's true. It's,
well, the big
clear
thing with Tipperary, their confidence was shattered. They were beaten in a league final that, you know, they felt they could have won, and the whole of Tipperary was down on top of the players, but they have regrouped and they've slowly built their confidence, and, you know, they're still not probably at full tilt, but what a very, very good performance today, and they will improve again, provided they get through now today, to improve again to the final.
Good work by Brendan Maher. Mark Ellis, fingertips, didn't hold on to it. Seamus Callanan does. And that's 2 goals and 3 points. The full forward has scored in a really impressive performance. For the first time in this championship campaign, Owen Kelly is on the field. And listen to the response from the Tipperary fans. Going off is another great of Tipperary hurling, Lark Orbit. Brendan Maher. Conor Maher just didn't quite hold on to it. Stephen McDonald under pressure. Damien Cahillane. Daniel Carnick in the middle. James Barrett underneath it. Good play by the centre half back. Fine catch. Christopher Joyce. Dropping it in again. Dangerous enough ball. Darren Gleeson is coming off his line. Kieran Bergen says he'll deal with it. Dennis Maher is available in front of us here, but the defender goes long. Larkon McLaughlin. Poor ball. Easily intercepted by Shane McGrath. Over for his Conor Maher. Nobody coming through the middle at the moment. And Conor Maher realizing he's going for it. Who got the last touch? Didn't go out over the end line. And the Cork defenders, what were they thinking here? Shane O'Neill responded. But their confidence, even that little sequence of play, Michael, would show that the Cork confidence is shattered.
It is. You know, it's hard to believe how poor a performance this is from Cork. Really been, you know, destroyed all over the field. And the Tipperary forwards are really doing what they like at this stage. Lovely score by Noel McGrath again.
It's his second point in the game. He's had about 3 or 4 wides, but again, he's such a good hurler that he kept at it, and he knew eventually he'd find the range.
Yeah, I think, you know, as I said, Conor Maher was moved into the corner. Noel McGrath moved to centre forward. Lahr out in the wing. You know, they did their homework at half time. They identified the weaknesses in the Cork defence, and they exploited them fully in the second half. And, you know, very impressive display by Tipperary.
Dennis Maher. Still Maher. Gathers. He has Noel McGrath available. Seamus Callanan is now directing traffic, telling him where he wanted the ball to be placed, and that is over the bar. Seamus Callanan has been a source of difficulty from Cork since about 3:30 this afternoon, and it hasn't changed.
Yeah, I think all year, Marty, since the start of this National League, it's like if Seamus Callaghan had decided this was going to be his year, and he's been fantastic all season and brilliant again today. And Bonnarumma getting a massive reception now as he goes off. He's had a great game again today.
Bonnarumma makes way. Fort, new up-and-coming player, wonderful under-21 star this season. Podima. Owen Kelly, middle of the field. It would have been a perfect ending to his introduction, but it's just to the left and wide. Cork making another substitution. This is Jamie Collin, and it's Seamus Harnady that's going off. And for the first time this season, Cork fans leaving early in a championship match with their hurlers involved. Major disappointment. Daniel Carney continues to work hard, tries to set up Rob O'Shea. Paddy O'Sullivan is outmarked with so many players, so many Tipperary defenders back there, it's almost impossible. In comes Callanan again, flicks it back towards Owen Kelly. That's going to be a free this time for Cork. Well, nobody would quite have anticipated that this would happen.
No, I couldn't see this happening today. I think there's two elements to it. Tipperary have played very well, but Cork have been very poor. And here's Michael Cahill coming in now as well. And, you know, this is good management now by Tipperary. They're keeping all the players on their toes. Michael Cahill will certainly not be happy being left out of the team today. But every one of the six defenders have been excellent. And, obviously they've been going on form and trend, and he didn't get in there. And nobody wants to give up their place for the All-Ireland final now.
Patrick Horgan lays it off, blocked on this occasion. Good effort by Jamie Collin getting his first touch. Paddy Stapleton, they're queuing up to Tipperary here. Here's Michael Cahill, over for his Dennis Maher. Nice skill by Maher, but then gives it away. Christopher Joyce, Bill Cooper, middle of the field. It's a rather poor effort, I'm afraid, by the old man. His work rate is phenomenal, but just on this occasion, Jimmy Barry Murphy and his team would be so disappointed with the performance and with shooting like
this. I think
so.
I think it's the performance, Marty, more than anything. The Cork were here last year. They were pucking the ball away from being All-Ireland champions, and really intent on getting back this year and making it to the final and giving it a rattle, but they've been completely out-hurled today. They never turned up, and Tipperary have dominated in every sector of the field, and, you know, you couldn't really say, maybe outside of Conor Lehan, Lorcan McLaughlin did reasonably well. Outside of that, they've been hurled off the field.
Long ball from Bill Cooper. It's down for Conor Lehan. Laying it off for Stephen Moylan. There's a chance here for Rob O'Shea. Good Cork goal. It's a little bit of too little too late, but it still will give Cork a little bit of confidence. The substitutes combining here and ending with Rob O'Shea cracking the ball into the net.
Yeah, well worked goal, and brings the gap down to 10 points. Rob O'Shea, a new player on the scene now. He took it very well, shortened up the grip there and flicked it inside the near post. And James Owens having a word with Tat Horgan.
So the referee.
Carl Barrett.
Carl Barrett and Patrick Horgan, I think both getting yellow cards for an off-the-ball incident. Conversation continues. Brian Cody will now realise it's another Tipperary Kilkenny. And listen to the crowd in Croke Park, because they see Brian Cody image up on the big screen. The old rivalry is alive and well, and we really look forward to it on September 7th.
He saw the funny side. He didn't look too nervous to me anyway, but he might become September.
Just for your information, out of Tipperary's 2 goals and 18 points, here's a statistic again that's frightening. Tipperary have scored 217 from play.
It's a huge statistic, and what it says maybe as well is how loose the Cork backs are. They haven't been even in close enough to give away frees, to foul. They've just made it far, far too easy. for the Tipperary Forest to win possession and to take them on. And you know, it's been a cakewalk really for that forward line.
Puck out from Anthony Nash. Easy ball for Shane O'Neill to gather. Rob O'Shea. Nicely picked up by Jamie Collin. Putting it into the middle, Christopher Joyce. First touch just left him down. James Barry is there. One-handed gets it out for us, Dennis Marr. Cork have it again. Larkin McLaughlin. It's goals, goals, goals now they need. And that's gone off Paddy Marr for a 65.
Yeah, Tipperary have obviously taken their foot off the pedal now. Cork looking for goals, and the intensity is gone. The game is over and just going through the motions now. And goes back to the traditional Tipperary and Kilkenny have produced a number of great finals over the last few years, and you know, it should be another fantastic All-Ireland final now involving two of the big three.
Ball has been dropped in, and that ball is wide. 10 points between the teams. Look at Eamon O'Shea. Passion, determined. He has never lost focus when at times Tipperary gave some disappointing performances. But he always believed his team were good enough. My gosh, they were good enough today, I have to say. Damien Cahalan, 1 minute of additional time going to be added on here. Cahalan to Rob O'Shea. Good work again by Brendan Marr. To John O'Dwyer. And as they say, it's as good as a score, but the ball is wide. Christopher Joyce, after the high of winning the Munster Championship and the heartbreak of the All-Ireland Final defeat last year, you sense that Cork, the graph was upwards all the time, particularly with the addition of so many good players, but this is a major disappointment. Darren Gleeson produces a good save. Stapleton is there, comes back past Bill Cooper, flicks it back outside, there's a chance of another goal, and again Gleeson saves! Excellent goalkeeping by Darren Gleeson. Not once, but twice. Full marks for the Bourke Road goalkeeper. He's waited for his chance since 2008 when he was sub-goalkeeper to Brendan Cummins. But when they put in the Rasper, Gleeson saved not once, as I mentioned, but twice.
Yeah, he's been fantastic today. As you said, he's waited so long. He showed great resilience to stick in there for the Tipperary cause, with Brendan Cummins obviously dominating in the goals for so long. And he's made three fantastic saves at least today. He's played very, very well. And his puckouts have been a huge feature of the game. The short puckouts, and Cork never really got the grips of that throughout the game.
Definitely one of the talking points is Darren Gleeson's puckouts. They were part of the Eamon O'Shea strategy, short puckouts, which worked all through this afternoon. It's going to be a Tipperary Kilkenny All-Ireland Hurling Final on Sunday, September 7th. Seamus Callanan scored 2 goals and 4 points as Tipperary steamrolled the Munster champions with a massive scoreline from play of 2 goals and 17 points out of 218. Jimmy Barry Murphy, always a gentleman, congratulates his conqueror on this particular day. Congratulates Eamon O'Shea. Brendan Maher does the same with his opponent. Darren Gleeson had 2 wonderful saves at the end, but his puck-out strategy was important. Heartbreak for Bill Cooper. The championship journey for Cork is over. Anthony Gleeson could do absolutely nothing about those 2 cracking goals by Seamus Callanan. But for Tipperary, well, they've something to look forward to. Kilkenny in September.
Absolutely, Marty, but you'd have to say a fantastic team performance, I thought, by Tipperary today. Right throughout, from 1 to 15, they produced, you know, none of their players had a poor game. Their midfield was the area that really impressed me. 6 points from play, 3 by Shane McGrath, 3 by James Woodlock. John O'Dwyer with 6 points from play, and Seamus Callanan with 2-4, 2-3 from play. Like, they're fantastic contributions. And, you know, Tipperary have put in a brilliant team performance. Cork are going to be very, very disappointed to come up here today with so much hope, huge following, massive support for Cork here today, and to go home, you know, and put in such an incipient performance, they're going to be very disappointed. But you have to credit Tipperary. They came here under the radar slightly, underdogs, but they've, you know, they're certainly put themselves into the frame now, and the All-Ireland final very much 50-50 now after today.
When you look at the scorers, Michael Jackson, Shane McGrath, 3 points. James Woodlock, 3 points. Both midfielders from play. John O'Dwyer, 6 points from play. Seamus Callanan, 2 goals and 4. Lark Corbett is the only forwards that didn't actually score today.
And maybe Bonard Maher didn't get a score either, but or maybe he did get one, I'm not sure. But yeah, certainly the midfielder. I said we're fed up all week of all of us saying the so-called experts predicting that Cork would clean them out midfield. That didn't happen, so great win for Tipperary.
Great win for Tipperary. They're in the All-Ireland final. Let's go down to Claire McNamara, who's joined by Seamus Callanan.
Seamus, congratulations. Tipperary always on top today. Very much helped by your 2 goals.
Look, it's a great win. I don't mind who scores them, but it's just to be good to be back to an All-Ireland final, I suppose. And look, we've no medals yet, so hope for the best.
Must be hugely satisfying to you, though, to put in that performance here on the big stage.
Yeah, but like you look around the field and, you know, the forwards are nothing without the work rate of everyone else out the field. We might get the plaudits at the end of it, but so it's a massive effort put in by everyone inside in that dressing room, you know, from 1 to 31, and everyone involved in the back room as well, you know, so just glad for everyone there.
It's been a pretty complete performance by Tipperary today. It's quite a turnaround this season for you, isn't it?
Well, I suppose just, we didn't have the luck maybe at the start of the year, things just weren't going our way. But it's you know, it's not luck, it's due to hard work, really. And look, we've not won yet, so we're taking step by step.
You're exactly where you want to be in back in an All-Ireland final.
Yeah, well, look, it's everyone's aim, I suppose, at the end of the year to be there the first week of September. We're there now, it means nothing unless we want to win it now, so, you know, just knuckle down for the next few weeks.
And waiting for you there are very familiar foes, your other neighbours, Kilkenny. How do you feel about that?
Yeah, but look, Kilkenny are the benchmark for years, so, you know, we're striding to get to their level, I suppose. And look, we'll analysis on this now game tonight, and I suppose we'll kick off preparation again tomorrow, you know.
Congratulations on your performance today, Seamus.
Thanks a million.
Well done, Seamus, and well done to Claire McNamara, proud Tipperary woman today, on a full-time score here in Croke Park. Tipperary 218, Cork 111. It's Tipperary against Kilkenny in the All-Ireland final. Michael.
I think there are a lot of proud Tipperary people around Croke Park today. In the commentary box there, Marty Morrissey and Michael Dygan. There's a look at the stats for you. But in terms of those tip scores, the man that you heard from there a moment ago, what a fantastic performance by him, Seamus Callanan. 2 goals and 4 points, 2-3 of that coming from play. And also there in the half-forward line, John O'Dwyer put in a fantastic performance as well with 6 of tips points. So then, now we know who will be for the right to lift the Liam McCarthy Cup on September the 7th. It will indeed be Kilkenny versus Tipperary, bringing back, of course, memories of those epic finals between 2009 and 2011. And we will have that match live on RT1 television. And that, of course, as I said, is on Sunday, the 7th of September. Let's get the thoughts of the panel. Eddie Brennan, are you looking forward to meeting those fellas?
You're talking out.
Yeah, it'll be. Thankfully, I'm going to a tourist to plan a potential homecoming. But it was. It's going to be interesting again. You know, at the border at home, we're neighbours with Ballingarry, so that should be very interesting over the next couple of weeks. And definitely, should look. It's a throwback to 2009 forward. So it's going to be a brilliant build-up again. As a Kilkenny person, I'd be nervous about the neighbours now. You know, they're after creeping up all year.
As a Kilkenny person working in Vertus, by the way.
Yeah. So. Look, it creates a great old buzz coming into it, but you'd have to say today when you sit down and analyse the match today, Tip seemed to want it more. That was, you know, we looked at the scores and we looked at everything that went on that day, and we all thought it was going to be very, very close. But to be fair to Tipperary, they were very intense from the word go. They got their matchups right. The big thing for me though with Tipperary was they hunted down Cork players all day long. They dispossessed them. They didn't give them a minute on the ball. And that was ultimately the difference. I mean, we do talk about the systems and all sorts of things like that, and they are relevant and stats. But I would love to see the stats today in relation to Tipperary. They just cleaned out Cork in everything that went on the ground, and to win that dirty ball that we talk about, they wanted that ball that bit more than Cork today, and you'd just be very disappointed. As a Cork person, you'd have to say there's a lot of very dour cars going home, going south this evening.
We'll have to put up those stats again for you, Eddie, give you another look at them. We talked before the match, Cyril, about this was so hard to call. Whichever way you saw it, maybe Cork might win, maybe Tip might win. I have to say, I couldn't see that. I couldn't see that.
Fantastic move at
half-time. Which is basically what it was.
Yeah, but the move at half-time won the game. Noel McGrath went or Bonner Mark in corner, caused terrible trouble. I saw McGrath training. I went up to see the Tip senior team playing Galway 21s. I was the second Tip team, where I slipped across to see the senior team playing. That 6-6, Noel McGrath was brought centre-forward, pin and ball. Second half went out centre-forward. The Tip team got 2-17 from play. That's unbelievable against the Cork team that was in Dáil-Éireann last year. Like, Tip were flowing, we questioned some of their backs. Like, you know, Barry was brilliant full-back. All of a sudden, they're in full flow. Like, and you get 2-17 from play. They were all scoring. Maher didn't score, but he was fouled. He made so many scores. Noel McGrath eventually came into it. From all over, like, they got 6 points from midfield from play. So, like, they're in a strong position tonight. As Eddie says, like, they love playing Kilkenny. You know, and Brian Cody was there, like, he'd be smiling away. It's going to be another, there'll be 80,000 this time, not 70, like, and I'm looking forward to it already. But Tip are in a good position, they're on a roll, and you'd have to question, like, Cork being kind of, say, idle for the few weeks, like, they looked nervous.
Yes.
In the first half, they would turn a lot of wides, shots that they should be going over the bar, but when Tip got into flow, like, Tip were only up 2 points at half-time, after being completely on top. Second half, they got into flow, and they're lovely to watch. Okay, it's a sad day for Cork, they'll have to take it in the chin, but, like, Tip are coming, they're a gathering force, like, and you know, it's going to be some final.
But you'd say that Cork got their match, their game plan a bit wrong today. They seem to be very narrow. In the Munster final, they had six forwards playing six positions. Today, they seem to keep it very narrow, and I think that suits defences. They never opened up at all. They never put any balls spraying into the corner like they did in the Munster final.
But they weren't allowed. Having said all that, not alone is it a triumph for Tipperary, it's a triumph for Eamon O'Shea. You know, so many people questioned him down throughout the year. But at the start of the game today, you wouldn't have dreamt that those backs could cope with that far. Would only concede 1-11. In the whole game to what we thought was a very good Cork forward line. But from the goalkeeper, whose puck-outs were excellent, whose blocking was excellent towards the end, on through the defence. Now, Paddy Maher will get all the plaudits, but every one of those defenders dominated their men. Who would have thought that the two midfielders, Shane McGrath and Woodlock, would clean out the Cork midfield, who had dominated everybody else they'd met up to today, and not alone dominate them, but score 6 points?
Yeah.
But the movement, the support play of their forwards is exceptional. By any standard, it is exceptional and very hard to counteract. Now, at the end, you'll be saying Cork were very poor. But that movement wears down a defence. That constant movement, trying to catch up with them, trying to close them down, it wears them down. And they use the ball so intelligently, as Cyril they said, especially in the second half. They have turned into, he has turned these into a very, very serious force. And the final thing I say is, they might have new tactics, but what will please supporters most of all tonight is the old mentality. The mentality of old is back. That defiance, that steel that was missing for the last few years.
Not a direct ball in the first
half. But it's the mentality. It's that steel, that air of defiance they have, that we are not going to give in to our men. That, you know, that we'll attack everything. That old defiance of Tip that had in the past, that is back. And that's what makes them really dangerous when combined with that exceptional level of skill.
Joe, we'll take absolutely nothing away from Tip's win today because it was more than deserved. But just on the point, because Cyril alluded to it, The layoff, and this is a problem in the championship, both in hurling and indeed in football. One team playing matches, the other team sitting waiting to play. Had that any significance?
Michael, a big thing had this. The boys talking about the tactics. In the first half, Cork played seven backs, whether you like or not. Mark Ellis went back deep. Carney went back centre back. So in actual fact, when they were clipping up balls to Cork forward.
Yeah, but on that point of.
There is no question, because this has happened now over the last few years. It happened to Limerick last year as well. They came up here against the Clare team who had two or three games played and they were way sharper than them. So it's beginning to look like an advantage not to win your provincial title now.
But the only ones
who can master it are Kilkenny. Kilkenny can master it, you know, but there are a lot of distractions within Cork. And we saw today, listen, I'm going to say it again, you know, this dependence on a number of players who are playing football and hurling, it totally backfired on them today. You know, Aidan Walsh was cleaned out at midfield by Shane McGrath at midfield, and, you know, Damien
Cahill.
Well, you see, that's the whole thing. But when you come to Croke Park, listen, in Croke Park, you must be able to hurl. Your hurling must be razor sharp when you get out there on that field. And Tip had that sharpness there. Helped an awful lot, you're right, Michael, helped an awful lot by the fact that, you know, they have played Dublin since, they have played Offaly since, they have played Galway since. A gradual improvement, but you wouldn't still have expected the kind of improvement that has taken place from, we'll say, the Munster semi-final today. It's exceptional.
I disagree with that slightly. I think that comes down to attitude. It has to come down to attitude. I think, you know, you can talk about the layoff. If it goes for you, it's brilliant. It worked for us. If it doesn't, it doesn't. It comes down to attitude, and that was ultimately the difference today. Tipperary's attitude was just spot on. Cork just seemed to be a little bit at sea there today. They tried some stuff that didn't come off. Silly little passes here and there. They weren't as direct as they had been against Limerick. I thought they were very direct, and that was ultimately the difference. I think it's all to do with if your attitude is right and your hunger is right, then you'll get to the pitch.
Yeah,
and just simply today, Tip were.
That was typified though, Les, by Pádraic Maher from the very start. You picked him out there at the very start. Mm. He forced himself into every game. He caught the ball, walked through tackles, ate off. He dictated what Eddie is saying. His attitude was dead on. All the others followed through. And they eventually wore down Cork with kind of bearing into every ball.
It's time for our final break of the day. When we come back, we'll have more analysis and reaction to today's game. Plus, you could be heading to both of this year's All-Ireland Finals and to the GAA All-Stars Banquet. It's our latest competition, and the details are coming up shortly.
Black Hole in the Hearing the Champion, Schneegallis, going the Galtry tradition to Inirin, Agus, Nice Fudge again. Black TV for TG Care.
The way to survive in business is to react, not just quickly, but in the right way.
At Aircom Business Solutions, we know this too. That's why we provide you with everything you need to stay connected when it matters, where it matters. With our business bundles, you get landline, superfast broadband and mobile, even when you roam in the UK, Europe and the USA, starting from just €50 a month. Aircom, driving business forward.
Some moments teach you all you need to know about yourself. The Electric Ireland GAA Minor Championships. This is major.
Beautifully designed for work and play. The Nokia Lumia 930. Capture HD quality images, upload to OneDrive for access anywhere, and share via your favorite apps. The Nokia Lumia 930. One experience. Windows on your phone.
Tornado!
This one is bigger than any storm that has ever been.
Hang on!
Into the storm.
With Aircom Business Solutions, all mobile plans include roaming in the UK, Europe and the USA.
Three little words.
Where are you?
At three, we're building an even better network because every word of every call, text and tweet matters. Sometimes all you need are just three little words.
Is this free?
The network as it should be. Three.
Centra, sponsors of the GAA Hurling Championship.
Opel, official car partner of the GAA, are giving you the chance to win the ultimate GAA fan experience. They want to send you and a friend to the Opel All-Star Awards, where you will mingle with this season's celebrated stars. Plus, you'll attend both finals in Croke Park in September as the GAA season reaches its climax, along with an overnight stay in the Croke Park Hotel for each game and €1,000 spending money as well. For your chance to win, answer this. Which one of these teams declared defeat in the 2013 All-Ireland Senior Hurling Final Replay? Was it Dublin, Waterford or Cork? To enter, call 15 16 71 71 74 or text the word hurling followed by your answer and name to 57001. Viewers in the north can also text 57001 or call the number on screen. You must be over 18 to enter. Lines will close at midday on Monday, August 18th. Full details on www.rte.ie/competitions, where the lucky winner will also be announced.
All right, the best of luck with that. And back here on the programme now, we are joined by the Tipperary manager, Eamon O'Shea. Eamon, once again, many thanks for joining us. Many congratulations, first of all. A lot of people, Eamon, said this game was going to be too hard to call. You won it by 10 points. That must have actually ticked every box you could have imagined.
Yeah, well, it was a strange game in the sense that I think neither team in the first half would have been happy with the fluidity, you know, because I think there was a lot of talk about shootouts and so on like that, and I don't think there's ever going to be a shootout, certainly from our end. And I think probably Cork were the same, the way they set up. So in the second half then, I think we just worked our way to the win, really. That's the most pleasing aspect that, you know, I think we ground out a win today. Even though we did finish up with a 10-point win, I don't think there was any doubt in my mind that the team wanted to win that game. And, you know, whatever way the game would have turned, we would have won it.
Eamon, I think even Cork people would agree with this. They didn't perform today, you did. Where did that performance come from?
Oh, well, I think, you know, the performance has been building a bit, you know, and I mean, I disagree slightly about the performance. I think we lacked a little bit of fluidity in terms of forward play, and I think the forwards are disappointed at the moment. I certainly am. So I think we ground out. The best thing about the result was that we ground out the win. You know, we worked really hard, and so the team has, you know, the team has been through a lot. You know, they're not novices. Yes. You know, so they've been through 5, 6, 7 years, the 2/3 of the team, and I think the young players come in then and give us a bit of a bounce. You know, so I think it was a victory for the character and the resolve of the team and the resilience of the team that I've talked about all year. You know, you don't get as many knocks as we got without coming out with something.
You mentioned those knocks, Eamon. One game that had huge significance, I think, this season, I wonder, would you agree, was that game against Galway. They were, I think, 6 points up in the second half in the Championship against you, and you turned that around, won the game, not only won it, but won it well. Was that the turning point for you in the season?
Yeah, well, actually, it was a turning point, all right, but it was against Galway in the league, actually, at half-time, when we were down in Pier Stadium and we didn't play well in the first half and came back and got within 3 points of Galway and won the second half against the wind. You know, the team decided that, you know, enough was enough. And, you know, I think although we had a blip against a very good Limerick team, you know, who deservedly beat us, you know, you know, we were still very much together, you know, all the time. So there was no doubt in my mind that we would go on to at least be competitive, you know, and that's really where I was getting the confidence from. I think the lads had a good resolve to be competitive, you know, and I think that's what we showed today, you know, a desire to get over the line.
Excellent. Cyril has a quick question for you.
Eamon, well done there. Listen, at half time, you put Noel McGrath without centre forward and Bonnemar coming in corner. It seemed to work a treat. You did it at half time. When did you decide to do it? Had you might as well have done it?
Well, in fairness, Bonner was carrying an injury from about the 10th minute. I mean, Bonner was heroic today, to be honest with you, relative to the other players on the pitch, because he played for a lot of that game in pain. And, you know, I think that, you know, so we were trying to give him a little bit of protection as well. So, but we wanted Noel out there in any case. But, you know, I think I just can't pay enough to Bonner and his industry. Every ball that came up, he competed for it. And he's just an example to all players as to how to play this game.
There's no doubt about that. Eamon, you're almost there picking up that Liam McCarthy Cup. Just a small matter of Kilkenny to deal with.
Yeah. I have to think about that one for a few weeks. Yeah, it's Kilkenny, so you know, they probably had the beating of us the last couple of years, and but you know, everything is every game is different, and let's see what this one brings.
All right, listen, we will do exactly that. Congratulations once again today, Eamon O'Shea. Thanks
no
for
problem.
Joining us.
Thanks, Michael.
Yeah, he's done a fantastic job, in fairness to him.
Well, you see there the secret, the confidence he has in the players. Mm. And even when things were going badly, you know, earlier on in the year, he still maintained. Every time he was saying, we're on the right road. Even after he'd been beaten, we're on the right road. And all that confidence transfers down to the players. He had total belief in them. They have total belief in him. And that really, that's all that matters. You know, what criticism comes from outside doesn't matter really, because we're looking at it from a different angle. He was looking long term. He was looking about the McCarthy... towards the McCarthy Cup this year, and you know, he has got them now within a step of it.
You have to look at what you're in control of, really. And when you're a bunch of players like that, you're only in control of the four walls that you're within as a group. You know, you can't let outside influences dictate too much. Okay, people like us are here to do a job, and print media and all the rest of it. And you call it as you see it, and you'd have to say that Tip are poor as the year, but they have built nicely, and they are now standing on the brink of an All-Ireland final, which is, you know, down to the wire against our own lads.
Well, I asked them that question, Michael, was I saw their training match. They played Galway under 21, but it was a Tip backup panel.
Yes.
But I saw the senior team. It was 6 against 6, you know, kind of flying in the ball, but they played Noel McGrath, kind of midfield, centre-forward, and everybody got, he was laying it off, they getting return pass. So I was just interested when he'd say, OK, Mar was probably injured, didn't show the pitch, he got every ball. But Noel McGrath, even in the first set, he was missing things. But when he's in full flow, he's beautiful to watch, and he has the wrist. And any time, the last great game he had was centre forward as well against Waterford. If you think of that day, he was popping back out midfield and shooting from outside. He has the ability to shoot from 60 or 70 yards. But when you add in Bubbles, Dwyer and these guys, all of a sudden they're on a different level. And to score 217, now Eamon is playing it down, but to score 217 from play, it's very hard to do that in the semi-final.
I did it, and the man who did it again today for them, Seamus Callanan. Two goals today. Let's have a look at the second one.
Yeah, the second goal, you'd have to say, was probably the big knockout punch, and it came from a Cork at the other end. And you see Noel McGrath here, wins a ball, carries it forward. The point was probably on from here, but vision to spot a pass that maybe wasn't on. But again, you just see the work rate from Garrod Ryan and the Bonner, of course. That's great vision. And look, over to Seamus Callanan. He's a forward that is just bang on confidence at the moment. And you know, that's a finish of pure confidence. We're watching his movements here. You know, he's placed ideally, comes out, just probing really. And then when Bonner gets the ball, he just peels off nicely. Bonner doesn't even have to look up. And that is a forward with just playing on the best of confidence at the moment. And when you're a forward and your confidence is up like that, it's just instinct. You don't even have to think about where you're putting it. You don't even have to look at where the goalie is. It's instinctive. And you'd have to say his finishes today, two of them were right.
Already you'd be looking forward to the battle between himself and JJ Delaney in the final. You know, it's probably one of the most watering things.
Bonner actually won the ball that he shouldn't have won. He wins the hard ball. And as Eddie says here, Callanan peeled off, rocketed in it.
But sure, Bonner has been doing that forever.
We heard from Maven O'Shea. Let's just quickly get the thoughts of the Cork manager, Jimmy Barry Murphy.
Jimmy, no one expected that performance today from Cork. Can you give us some insight?
I don't know, really. It's too soon after the game to do an in-depth analysis of it. But just very, very disappointed that we didn't bring anywhere near like the quality of the game we'd like to bring to give Tipperary today. And very disappointed for the players and the supporters.
because we had thought you'd come in here very confident given the experiences of last year and given that you were coming here as Munster champions.
That's right, yeah, that's why it's most disappointing. But I mean, I don't want to take from Tipperary or anything like that, but our display was poor today, and too many of our players were comprehensively outplayed throughout the field. And I think when that happens, particularly when a Tipperary defence are coming out with the ball and clearing it and able to find their forwards in space and use that space, then you're going to pay for it, and I think that's what happened to us today.
Was there a lack of confidence? What do you put it down to?
I don't know really. I mean, as I say, it's too early to analyse it. But I think too many of our players were comprehensively outplayed throughout the field today. And as I said, when that happens, you're plugging gaps everywhere, and we just weren't good enough on the day.
Having said that, we were just 2 points adrift at halftime.
That's right. I thought we were lucky to be 2 points adrift only, because it could have been worse. And we felt we hadn't played well at all. So from that point of view, I was reasonably happy going in that we might produce a better display in the second half, but it didn't improve. And the second goal then really killed it off, I thought, and our heads dropped, which was disappointing. But again, you know, in fairness, as I said, lads have been great for us over the last couple of years, and we've all had days like this when it doesn't really go for you, and that's the reality of sport, I suppose.
Very soon after defeat, as you say, but I suppose you have a Munster Championship to look back on with pride, and also you've brought through on some new players.
Yeah, I suppose that the Munster Championship is some consolation, but it doesn't feel that way today, because I suppose in Cork you're judged on all Ireland you win, and we just have fallen short now as a management team. That's the reality we're facing. But I mean, everyone can't be a winner, and I think Tipp's display today deserves great credit, and they have good players who can punish you, and they did that today.
Thanks, Jimmy.
Thanks, Claire. Cheers.
Yeah, generous in his analysis of that. You can clearly see Jimmy Barry Murphy shattered after that.
Yeah, he is, because it's his third year, like he's 3 years there now, and he felt he was building this team, you know, to win in All-Ireland. And, you know, going from last, having been in the final last year and just barely, you know, edged out at the end, especially in the first day, you know, to bring in five new players and to feel that the structure of his team was way, way better than it was last year, and to see the whole team, not just the new structure it's in, but the whole team really demolished, because you can hardly think of any position that they won today. Maybe Conor Lehan did okay, bring forward, score, bring back. But to see the forwards so totally dominated by the tip backs, and to see, his backs then opened up so clearly by the Tipperary forwards. And, you know, one of the most interesting things there that Eamon O'Shea was said that he wasn't happy with the forwards this week.
Yes.
Right. Now, if you said before the game that four of the Tipperary forwards would only score 1 point from play between them, would you think this Tipperary would score 217 from play? But that's what happened.
Yeah.
And it just shows, like, that they're not. It's not the individual performance of Tip. It's the whole work rate, the whole movement. That work rate, that movement, as the lads there showed with the goal, you know, men moving out. Next thing, they're gone in a different direction. Next thing, one man gets the ball, another man lose, and a score.
It's going to
be very hard to counteract that, even for such a great defence as Kilkenny.
They're very comfortable on the ball, you see. They are very good hurlers. The Bubbles, one of these guys, can make the ball dense if they want to, if you give them space. As Gerard says, like, if they get enough ball. Now, Jim Barry Murphy referred to there, the tip backs were so much stuff, they could look up and place the ball. Now, early on, they were hitting it very high, and Cannon caused trouble early on, but after a while, they snuffed them out, you know what I mean? They got on top of it. But when they started placing the ball the second half, it was like poetry in motion. It was lovely to watch.
But even in the first half, when they got their goal in the first half, there was a kind of a looseness to the game that you kind of more expect maybe the last 15 minutes of the match.
The boys here were saying they couldn't understand. It was loose, and it was kind of terrible, kind of silly mistakes kind of happening and bobbing around the place. Now, Seamus Cannon has a lot to do here. He gets this ball, and he has goal in his mind here, but when he cuts in, he lets the ball across, breaks down here, this is coming up, this is a good goal here. Now McGrath, this guy had a great game, playing for his life because he wasn't on the team all year round, goes up along the pitch and has a look out. Now Shane nightmares about this because he missed the ball here. Now Shane Cannon, I was sure when he came out he was going to tap the ball over, but the lad playing in confidence, he rifles into the net, once the one spot that he can get. If you watch it here, McGrath has the ball and he goes down along the side and he takes a little look, squares a little bit. I thought he was going to bring him back more, squares across. Now O'Neill gets out in front and you could be given out to Cannon, where the hell is he? But O'Neill misses the ball and Shamey gets on the ball. But here, you'd imagine, when he gets it, he goes back out, not in, because he doesn't control the first touch, back out. I thought he was going to tap it over, but he sticks into the back of the net. You'd have to say that his two goals, the one in the second half, killed him off. The one in the second half was the icing on the cake, because that killed him altogether. He's playing with confidence. In Tipperary, Michael, the whole time, they're questioning this fella's mentality. They know he has the ability, but the temperament for the big day. Now, the next big day is going to be bigger, because he's coming up into the king of the fullbacks at the moment is JJ Delaney. And if he's able to handle JJ Delaney, he's able to handle anyone.
Listen, his goals all season have been so important, but there were a couple of other things today, Eddie, for me, that, if you like, showed the difference between the two sides. Things, you know, it's one of those days, or was one of those days, where things were going right for Tip. Now, maybe they made them go right, and not quite so for Cork. Here's just one or two little examples. This was a Cork attack. Ended up in a John O'Dwyer point.
Yeah, it was a good goal chance for Cork. And, you know, Bill Cooper even here, you know, just that's a very ambitious pass across. And you know, to be fair to James Barry, he keeps his eye on the ball the whole way across. And this is what I spoke about earlier about Tipperary. Their intensity, they tackled very, very hard, and they were always looking up then. Garrod Ryan, you know, was quite enough today, but route one ball in, and it came out to Bubbles Dwyer, and you'd have to say, you know, Seamus Callan just rises just a little touch out, the simple things, and that was ultimately the difference. I think, Michael, what you're trying to say there is that Tip just scored that little bit easier. There was more fluidity
to their play. Seamus wins this ball off two Cork defenders.
Yeah, Mark Ellis, to be fair to him, I thought was probably the one Cork player that really stood up today. He cleared an awful lot of ball. I think he kept them in the match in the first half when it looked as if Tipperary potentially could have gone to town. And the one mistake he made, it just bounced out of his hand when they looked to be in control of that situation. And look, Callan was there to pounce on it like a good forward should be. But don't underestimate the danger of a team coming into an All-Ireland with plenty of confidence.
Oh, yeah.
You know, that is ultimately what you want. And we look at Tipperary in 2010, they've done something similar. They built and built and built. And that makes them very, very dangerous opposition.
Yeah. They can keep you up, you're confident.
No, it is very...
I know, they're confident, but yeah. I suppose, look, the man himself was there casting an eye over it. And I mean, we know, Kilkenny will know themselves, if they're being honest, they have work to do. They'll know the dangerous animal now that they're facing in the All-Ireland final. And okay, so there's certainly a lot to do for them, and makes it very interesting. We'll see who'll be dancing then.
We surely will. All right, we're almost wrapped for another Sunday here at Croke Park, but plenty more Gaelic games to look forward to here on RTE. Now you can relive Tip's win in today's semi-final on the Sunday game tonight with Des Cahill and guests, and that's at 9:30 here on RTE2. And we'll also be announcing the Centra RTE Man of the Match from today's game, as well as featuring action from today's minor semi-final. And then the build-up to next weekend's first football semi-final begins on Friday on RTE2 with Thank GA It's Friday. That programme is at 8:30. And we are, of course, back here next Sunday at Croke Park as Kerry and Mayo go head-to-head.
Four in a row would appear to be on the way for Mayo.
It's O'Shea!
An amazing kick on what is turning out to be a wonderful day for Kerry.
What a brilliant goal! Unstoppable! We'll play Kerry in the All-Ireland football semi-final.
Yeah, that's all to look forward to. In the meantime, my thanks to Gerard, to Eddie and to Cyril for their company this afternoon. Well, they travelled in their thousands to Croke Park this afternoon for this unique All-Ireland hurling semi-final. And it's the people of Tipperary who will head home this evening with a spring in their steps and a smile on their faces. Until next week, take care.
It's got glamour, style,
let's go,
and a whole lot of personality.
I know we only met, but let's pretend it's love.
But most
Constable, it's a bit of crack. The festival where anything can happen, and usually does.
Do you know me?
Yes.
The Rose of Tralee starts Monday at 8 on RTE1 and RTE1 HD.
Celtic have been handed a lifeline in Europe's premier club competition. Oh, yeah! Now, all that stands in their way of a third successive group stage appearance are Slovenian champions Maribor.
And it's there!
The UEFA Champions League playoff stage first leg. Maribor versus Celtic. Wednesday at 7:30 on RTE2 and RTE2 HD.
The UEFA Champions League programme on Wednesday will be brought to you by Nissan and MasterCard, UEFA Champions League sponsors.